Well, as I pulled up to this red light intersection of, I believe they call that Roos Street and Logan, a car was in front of me. He was stopped for the red light. I slowed down and was beginning to stop when the light turned green. The other car on our left had stopped in Roos Street like he was supposed to for the red light. The car in front of me went through the green light and I followed through, and his pickup came around in the passing lane and didn't stop and caught me and put me on the front end grill, kind of like a fly or a bug splattered.
Well,
now you know how a love bug feels, huh?
True. Do I ever. Talking about jarsy good. But what was nice about it was that they were able to, they kept the other traffic off of me there real good, and it didn't take them no time to, they had me loaded and gone. And all.
But that was about the only good thing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
They were there and ready to go.
You better believe it. I was surprised at of course, when you hit like that time, that you don't really have the concept of time, you know, just events there. And they pulled up and they put me on a board, you know, transport. Now that smarted, but once they got me on the board, I didn't hurt too awful bad.
Now tell me about the neck brace.
Oh, if I had my full helmet on, you should have seen those guys try to put a neck brace on me, under that. They got so frustrated. They pulled my head up and tried to put it underneath me, and then they tried to put it around my neck, and finally they just give up and just slapped it right on my neck like it's a neck. But my helmet, you know, really protected my whole jaws and everything. See, I hit the front end, all my side here hit. The whole front end, you know, you're down in a sitting position. Mm-hmm. So I took, my helmet took the hit.
And the helmet hit the hood, huh?
Yeah. It hit the hood.
And the ground?
And then when I went the other way, apparently I bounced the other way because I've got both shoulders black and blue on it. Mm. I've got a little bit of rope, a little bit of
gravel ring.
Yeah, on this one, but not much. In other words, it just knocked me through the air and dropped me. So I consider myself real lucky. I didn't.
I wasn't under that real bed. Good, was it?
Yeah.
The man was looking real good for you. Helping you.
Yeah.
You gonna ride again?
Tell him what's good he done picked out.
I'm gonna give him one of them Scare Bears 500s. My wife says I can't have it, so I gotta get a tricycle.
Yeah, she says tricycle, he says Scare Bear. We'll see who wins.
But I guarantee you it won't be blue. It'll be a different color.
Well, I hope it don't take you as long as it did me to get back on one after an accident.
Oh.
It took me about 15 years before I'd ever get on one.
Get on another one?
Yep.
Well, guys, you got to remember it was February when I broke this leg on it and broke five ribs. And I'm just healed up good enough for we can make those trips. We made, got back here and slammed up me again.
And that was right before
they
the trip.
They might be telling you something.
I'll tell you one thing, you think I'm going to get back on that bicycle. On that one, you're wrong. I'm not riding that one.
I understand.
Put your money on that. I don't care if they could fix it up.
You're just not going to ride that one.
I won't ride that one. That's a bad luck fight, buddy. Hmm.
We had a lousy ride today. You wouldn't enjoy it. It was raining and wind blowing.
Yeah, I could see how bad it was out there.
The road was rough and the food was bad. So you didn't miss nothing, Bill.
Oh, I was looking out there. I told Larry was in earlier. I told him, I said, you should have been riding with those boys. And he said, well, I couldn't do that. But he was thinking about that food over there at Shucks. Oh, that's a good place to eat. He was thinking about you all on the trip.
Is that good or going to be fixable?
I don't really know. From what I understand, all the plastic is busted on it.
Yeah.
It's slam dunked. In other words, all the pieces are busted. My tires are good, and it sets up on the stand. All right. My handlebars, I think, is busted. And of course, the windshield's wiped out. So they might be able to.
If the forks aren't damaged.
Yeah.
Or the frame.
Yeah. If the frame and forks all right, then I might be able to just ride it that way. It'd be easier fixed then. I could get to the motor easier.
Yeah.
Change.
Then the next time you get hit, you wouldn't have to worry about
buying all that plastic bag. Oh, me.
I don't go through that again, do you?
No.
No. It's not pleasant.
No. No. That's a sad feeling when you know you're going to get hit and there's nothing you can do. I just went like that. That was it. But I hope the next time to avoid all those. I'm almost to the point where I'll, like a bicyclist, get off my bicycle and push it across. So I could.
Well, we're just going to make right hand turns.
Just make right hand turns.
That's right. That's why it took us so long to get here.
Just make right hand turns. Oh, Lord.
So when are they going to work on your leg Monday?
Yeah, supposedly Monday.
Down here or up here? Where?
Yeah. Right there, where
here, right in here?
Yeah, take okay. It over there.
Real no, quick. I don't need to look at it. I just wondered.
I don't want to see it.
Well, how's your ankle?
It got above my ankle, so I may be getting by all right on it. I don't know.
Okay.
The doc said he's going to put some rods in and some plates and some pins. So I don't know.
So you'll never be able to fly again?
No, I won't be able to. Yeah.
You won't want to pass through the metal detector.
Oh, that metal detector will blow it wide open. It'll be nothing. That's better than a paid leg, though, I guess. I don't know. You know, Charlotte.
You've been walking.
Yeah.
No, and not like you'd like to be, but at least you're not going to have to lay in bed.
Hopefully not.
Yeah. No, you won't have
you
to.
Will.
Or you want us to walk around out there at the graveyard and find a plot for you one?
Oh, I hope not. I hope it's already filled so I won't have to go there.
Yours is already full, huh?
Yeah.
You got a lot of years yet.
Boy, I tell you. Yeah, my oldest first cousin called me off. You know, all of my family's dead except for my first cousins. And she's in 91 or 92. She called me. She says, well, says you must be in pretty good spirits. I said, yeah. I said, I'm pretty good spirits for a guy that knows how a bug feels when it hits your windshield. She says, like, she said, well, I said, I just got back. She'd been over in South Carolina. Her kids had taken her over there. She'd got to go to the beach and whatever, you think, around the historical stuff. She likes that. She was real happy. But at the end of the month, I was supposed to go to a Bell reunion up in Tennessee. And she She said, well, I don't guess you'll be making that. I said, no, don't think I might well be either. I'd be lucky if I get out of here for then.
You gonna be in there for a while, aren't you?
Yeah, the surgeon said it, probably around 14 days.
No.